Hey everyone, in this video, I wanted to show you how you could create a square Facebook video, basically a 1:1 aspect ratio video for Facebook using Adobe Premiere. In order to do that, I basically edited my sequence in a regular sequence. This is a 1920 by 1080 sequence that I would use in any other video that's shot in that format. But now I wanna take this sequence and make it square. So in order to do that, I need to create a new sequence. So I'll come up here to File, New, and I'll go to Sequence here. And these are the ratio, these are the aspect ratios of the sequence I usually get. They're usually 16:9 here. As you could see, this is the one I'm using right now, 16:9. But a 1:1 aspect ratio is gonna be a little different, and none of these options have that, so I'll have to create a custom one. So this is how you do that. I'll basically start with any one of these. I'll just click that one. And this is the sequence that is created for me, sequence two. I'll go over here and I'll basically command click or right click on the sequence, and I want to change the sequence settings. So I'll go over here, sequence settings, and I'll see my aspect ratio or the frame size right here, 16:9. What I wanna do is change this to square. So basically my horizontal and vertical frames need to be the same size. That's how I will get a square shaped image. So I'll just go ahead and change this to 1080. So now I'll have a 1080 by 1080 or a 1:1 video size. And I'm gonna go ahead and change the sample of the audio right here, sample rate to 44:1. Facebook likes that more also. So 1080 by 1080 square, press okay. So there we go. Now we have a square video here. So now if I go back to my edit and if I select all, and I'm gonna just command copy here, and I'll bring it here and I paste it right to this sequence, I should get my video right into the square format. Now the next thing I wanna do is, if I don't like how this is gonna, because it's basically cropping the side of this video. So this video is actually 16:9, so it's cropping it a bit. So in order to fit this to screen, I'll basically have to select one of these, and I need to come here to my effects tab. So I selected it and came to the effects tab up here, and I need to scale the size down to fit the screen. So right here, if I bring it to that size right now, it's fitting the screen, 58. And it's gonna give me the option to put text up here if I wanted to, and I do wanna do that. I actually have two text files that I'm gonna bring onto it to go throughout the video. You could also reframe this to fit the image if you wanted to do that instead. But let's go with something like this here. I'll just go with 60. I think that's a good size for my square dimensions. And I could either go ahead and do this to all my clips, or I could just select this and I could copy, and then I could come to these other clips and I could just go ahead and select these and then command control click or right click and paste the attribute. That will allow me to paste the attribute of the motion here. So I'll just go ahead and do that, press okay. I'll just have to select the other clips I have. I'm just shift selecting these. And then again, I'm gonna control click on a Mac or right click, paste attribute, motion, okay. So now everything should give me the same shape that I had for the one I selected. So basically, usually I would come to the first clip, I would select it, I would change the scale of it, and then I would go ahead and copy that and apply it to the rest of my clip. Just basically copy and then select everything else and then click and paste attribute. And I would use motion to do that. So now we're almost there. So I want to use the text files that I've created here. And in the new Premiere, the way you do that is you go up here to graphics, new layer, and you click text layer. Just like that, is created a text layer, and then you could just go ahead and type what you want. I've already done that, so I'm gonna delete this one. I'm just gonna grab this one and I'm gonna bring it over here, and I'm gonna stretch it all the way to the end of my sequence, and I'm gonna go ahead and put it in the black area right here on top. And then I'll do the same thing with this other one, bring it here, stretch it to the end of my sequence, and then I'm gonna bring it down to the bottom here. And I actually want to increase the file size of this top layer, so I'll come and select it here, the text source, and I just basically want to increase this file size. I'll just go ahead and drag this to be a little bit bigger. There we go. And I could always change where it's landing on my page. I'll put it right there. So now we just need to export the square shape and make sure it exports as a square video. So to do that, I'll come over here to File. I'll make sure the sequence is selected. I'll come to File. I'll go down to Export and Media. And here I have my square shape. Basically, what I want to do is match source. And it's already doing that, 1080 by 1080. I don't want to select any of these other options because it's going to change my aspect ratio that I've custom created. So H.264 is good for Facebook. And this is good. I just picked the first one, match sequence setting. Match source. And then I'll bring it down here. And I want to do two pass VBR. And I just need to change this to be a little smaller. Right now the file is 73 megs. I could make it even lower. So I could bring this down to 6 and 12. That gets me to about 45 megabytes. So 612 VBR 2-pass. And then I could name my sequence what I want. I'll just put it on the desktop here. And I'll press OK. And that's it. And I'll just press Export. And that's how you make a square video for Facebook. This should upload to Facebook. Facebook is going to do a little bit of compression to it, but you gave it a really good size to work with, so it should look pretty much the way you have it in Premiere. I hope this video was helpful. Please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel for a lot more how-to videos just like this one, and I hope to see you on the next video. Thanks for watching.